Well, hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. We're going to call this another 2012 Hell on Earth update. Something else I've been trying to wake you up about. It's not just the humans losing their minds, it's the animals as well. And they're on the attack. They're on revolt. It's only been a couple of weeks since I gave you such a report. There's already five headlines to talk about. Public was asked to watch for coyotes after an Aurora man attacked in his yard. City sent hundreds of flyers to residents on the city's near west side after they determined the animal that attacked was likely a coyote. Good Lord. Okay, coming right in your backyard, chomping on you. Then Tanzania, hyenas wreak havoc in Karatau, injure 20. Good Lord, hyenas attacking. And a pet lynx attacks a woman inside a Washington home. This is her pet. I don't know where we get off keeping lynxes as pets, but this one attacked. A woman suffered severe injuries to her arm after her boyfriend's pet lynx got loose and attacked her in their Bellevue home. The incident happened around Friday afternoon in the house at the 1900 block of 160th Avenue Northeast, and the 21-year-old woman was cleaning when the animal escaped its cage. Attacked her. Enough of you, bitch. A ferret attacks a baby girl in Pram in Burnley. A ferocious ferret attacked a 10-month-old baby girl as she was being pushed in her pram in Burnley. A foot-long animal ran up and jumped on Lola Mae Knowles' pram and bit her finger. Her frantic mum, Chloe Knowles, 21, shouted for help, and two firefighters who were driving past managed to get it off her. The youngster was taken to Burley General to have the puncture wounds on her finger checked out. Doctors x-rayed the hands, checked the animal had not caused damage to the finger bone, bandaged her hand, and gave her antibiotics to prevent infection. A ferret runs up on the stroller and bites you, baby. Just outlandish attacks. And last but not least, an elephant crushes a zoo owner to death with its trunk. The zoo owner was crushed to death in an elephant trunk after the animal she had spent 2 years nursing back to health picked her up and lifted her into the air, New Zealand Animal Welfare Authorities say. Helen Schofield, the owner and director of Franklin Zoo, 56 kilometers south of Auckland, was caring for a 3.1-ton Mila, formerly a circus elephant known as Jumbo, when tragedy struck. Emergency services were called to the zoo about 4:30. After receiving reports that Miss Schofield had been killed when Mila picked her up and crushed her. Auckland SPCA Executive Bob Carriage said she did not believe Mila had attacked Miss Schofield, who was also a vet. It would appear to be a tragic accident, he said. Just 2.5 hours before her death, Miss Schofield revealed details of the elephant's troubled emotional state during the talk to a group of 50 zoo visitors, including a Fairfax reporter, while standing in front of Mila's enclosure. So you see that? You talk bad about the animal and it kills you. Good Lord. 2012. Hell on Earth.